cheeky bastards.
Hey, welcome to Happy Hour. Matt. Mouse, Matt the Mouse, and new Joey.
I'm just Joey.
He's just Joey. Like just Jack Joey.
Definitely not a mouse.
He hangs out with mice.
Alright, today we're going to play through Resident Evil 1, the Mansion Incident. So let's do this, huh? Mansion Incident 1. You want to be Chris, you want to be Jill?
I'll let you be the girl this time.
Yeah, I like Jill. Oh, look at that. We got a grenade launcher that we can start off with. I'll stick with a submachine gun. So we found out we could upgrade our weapons, and we did that off camera. Wasn't very interesting. We just clicked a few buttons.
We also checked the settings of our game.
Yeah, there's nothing there really interesting. But you don't have to sit through that. Anyway, Mansion Incident. Resident Evil 1. The original.
Or director's cut if you're me, because that's what I played.
Well, I the first the time I played Resident Evil was the remake on the GameCube, so I never played the original either, with all the bad acting and the dialogue. I have seen all those cutscenes though. Just, I mean, you can't not see those cutscenes. I always love these old school Resident Evil. I know a lot of people don't like the way like they control, but I always love these fucking games.
Yeah, this one is like an ink, like the
ink ribbons. You had limited saves because you had your ink ribbons that you had to deal with.
Yeah, that was when I played on the PlayStation.
That was absolutely horrible for me because I'm the kind of person that likes to save stuff just in case you need it and then never use it. Yeah, Wesker was there. Wesker was fucking stars. We didn't know he was a traitor until the end of this game.
And like I said, I never beat it or anything.
Yeah.
I remember that table.
No, so Wesker is actually the head of the STARS unit. We end up out here. But yeah, he was a scientist for Umbrella. But none of us knew that until the end of this game.
I know you used this mansion as a model for one of our tabletops.
Yeah.
I don't... Was that table there?
Yes. We do end up heading to that room.
And he turns! Yeah, the classic scene there. Everyone remembers that one.
Yeah.
That was the scene.
It's funny. We're gonna just fill this fucker with bullets right now, but in the actual game, I just ignore him. Because it's real important to save ammo.
Yeah.
And, like, this is just... There's so much room in that particular area that you don't really have to. You don't really have to kill that guy, so I never did. We need to get out of
here. That guy's neck just
went everywhere. I thought I was blue for a while. I don't know why because I haven't been blue at all. So I was not aiming where I should have been. What are these things?
Whatever you want them to be, baby.
Get shit on. I like how they have the typewriter too.
I want to shoot it, kind of, but
I think it went by too fast. Yeah.
Turn around.
Okay. No. The vases. Wesker. Something isn't right. Maybe it has something to do with all these dead people walking around.
And the amount of them around.
Yeah, that's true too. There's like a lot of zombies in this house. Like, it's a big house, but... I never really questioned it, but I guess they probably...
Yeah, you open it and then there's...
The dogs, yeah. Well, in Resident Evil 1, there's... Game, yeah. You try to open it, the dogs come after you. I never really questioned it before, as I was saying, but, oh, fuck. Like, there are a lot of zombies in here, and I'm guessing they're probably mostly, test subjects, because there is a lab underneath this house. But, man, they had a lot of people. I guess it could have been scientists and stuff too.
Those scientists. What's that piece of paper?
It's like documents. There's just collectibles, really. There's a whole bunch in this game.
Doesn't benefit me.
No, not particularly.
That is not bullets.
Actually, I don't know if collecting that stuff would increase our score, though. Give us more stars so we can upgrade our stuff, so it might benefit us.
Just became possibly beneficial.
Yeah, I have no idea if it is, but...
Oh.
There's more. That's like the third one we picked up here. Which is funny, because we've hardly got any in Zero. They're finally smart enough to peek around a corner. And it was fruitless.
Dag.
Dag. Yeah, you fucked up. Yeah. You can't tell me that chandelier didn't look suspicious.
I can't. Only because I wasn't paying attention to this. But for all I know,
yeah, take my word for it. Take my word for it, man. That was a suspicious chandelier.
I'm trusting you, man. Man. I don't want to just be going out taking out chandeliers and shit. No reason. They're people too, man.
See, that's something we haven't been doing. We haven't been shooting doors. I just shut that door. We could have gone in. I think that guy wants to come inside. Oh, he's inside.
Shoot him in the ass. Shoot him in the ass.
That guy's inside too. Man, they just like...
Dive.
Like, yeah, like... Not even dive. They just like trip in.
Hey, this guy too? Guys.
Hey, you guys. Yeah, there he comes.
Let me in. I come.
They're just drunk. They're not even.
You guys want to hang out at the gamers' brew? Promise not to shoot you.
No, I don't promise that at all.
As long as you don't try to bite me, I'm cool with them. Man. Have a drink. Drink with the zombos.
Oh, man. See, it does tell us how many objects we destroy. So, we should be shooting chandeliers down. I'm curious as to what critical hits are, though. I mean, you would think they'd be headshots, but that's like all we hit, and we have not that many critical shots.
It's not crotch shots either, because I've been taking care of that business real good. I ain't sure get no zombie babies later. Zombaby.
I've been watching a lot of bad movies on Netflix recently, because I love watching bad movies on Netflix.
Dude.
Not necessarily bad movies, just not the best movies.
I finally saw Wolf Cop, dude.
I want to watch Wolf
it's
Cop.
It's so... They say it. They say it, and you get it. I'm not going to say when, but they say it. And you get really excited.
I gotta watch that one. I gotta watch Zombievers.
Zombievers is good, too.
I haven't seen that one either. It's a crimson head.
It's funny, we actually saw that at work, and you know, I mean, obviously with the name, you can expect to see a little bit of beaver and Zom and some other things. And like, not even like 10 minutes into the fucking movie, man, like just straight up boobs in their face. We're watching in the kitchen, servers are walking in and out, like, it's like, I just hope her boss doesn't fucking come in. Like, what the fuck are you guys watching? Like, it's a scary movie, dude. Like, never seen a scary movie. Titties and scary movies go hand in hand.
And scary movies, yeah.
So,
yep. You guys came up this stairway too in the campaign.
Yeah,
although it wasn't as much inside.
Oh, more lamp.
Suspicious looking lamp. Once again, the look around the corner.
I'm already shooting that guy. I don't trust it.
I'm gonna open the door, dude. Is this where? Oh no, it's not.
Egg.
Oh, that guy got fucked.
Oh, you're the girl this time. I got excited. I'm like, it was me. Dude. Like, that dag almost got you too.
get shit on. Unless you're into that, in which case, don't get shit on.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Like, that's exactly how I feel about, you know, the whole shit thing, man. Like, it's like, what do you do afterwards? Like, oh, it's time to clean the sheets again. Or get new, like, get to plan it. You're like, okay, pull out the new sheets. We prepared for this.
I mean, you could, like, oh, shit, I was not prepared for that. I mean, you could always, ironically, I was going to say, you could always prepare for it, you know? Lay down some plastic or something. I don't know. Like in Horrible Bosses, when he's gonna piss on the guys, they put down the, you know, the plastic first.
I'm just saying, man. And then, like, it's awkward, okay, I'm gonna go shower now. Like, what if, like...
I mean, it probably wouldn't be that awkward.
Or what if you're, like, a prostitute or something, that's like, you just charge extra for that, but it's like, hey, like, you're not gonna shower here. Like... It's like, oh, I have to leave and shit. Like, you know, like, night wasn't already bad enough. Like, gotta walk out with this shit on me. Literally. And I would say, I'm sure there's shitty guys out there who would deny a shower to someone, you know?
To someone they just shit on?
Yeah.
They just literally shit on?
Maybe his final, like, get off, you know?
Yeah.
Fucking.
Does it tell her to go fuck herself?
Yeah. Basically. Sucks, but I mean, that's what I'm saying, you know, there's
Some real assholes out there.
Just really.
Yeah, shit on someone, you could at least give them the courtesy of a shower.
Yeah. I'd let you shower, dude.
Thanks, man. That means a lot.
But I wouldn't shit on you.
So. Thanks, man. That means a lot.
Everywhere. Jesus.
Is he dead? He'll be dead.
That bird's scary. I just immediately thought Bloodborne, man. Thought the bird was going to start limping to me.
Oh, dude, it's
fucking
crow.
Marilyn Manson.
We felt that different. I think it's Brad Vickers. Or actually, I think they just said his name, so I probably missed it and I'm wrong. I'm not paying attention, guys. I'm sorry.
Forrest. Oh, it's
Forrest.
God damn it, Gump.
God damn it. I'm sure they probably just said his name. I'm like, oh, that's probably...
I accidentally shot that dog. Total accident would save my ass.
What I said doesn't even make sense. Vickers ran away. I know this.
Nerd.
You're just jealous of my mad Resident Evil knowledge, dude. Dropping that knowledge. Birds inside.
You got that mad trivia?
Yeah, dude. Mad because it's angry and mad because it's fucking awesome.
Double the mad.
Double the glad. Look out. Yeah, don't get up. It's fine. Fuck these birds. I hate live birds.
Why are the birds attacking us, man? Like, this is their problem. Yeah.
They're just being assholes, dude. Just being assholes, birds.
Like, what else can we throw in the game that'll piss people off? Like, throw some random birds fly at them. What's that?
How do the birds even... Oh, well, I guess they probably eat infected.
Okay.
Because... They explain it as rats are what spread the T-virus around the town and stuff. Because by Resident Evil 2, the whole town is infected. Which takes place immediately after this, so... So I guess the birds are, like, eating rats and shit.
By, like... I've played... Five...
Five was the one with Chris and Sheva in Africa.
Yeah, and, like, so how did you get that far?
Well, after this whole incident, Umbrella was... Ooh, you saved me, because I was not prepared for that. So Umbrella is the corporation that fucking did everything, right? After this incident that takes place in the first three games, they're, like, outed.
Uh-huh.
And, like, bioterrorism kind of takes the forefront of government concerns. Is this a... Yeah, it's a fucking snake. Oh, shit. Bioterrorism kind of takes the forefront of, like, worldwide government concerns. They form, like, a whole squad about it and everything. In Resident Evil 4, you play as the guy from Resident Evil 2, but he's trying to save the president's kidnapped daughter. And that's kind of separate from all this that's going on. Fuck you. But basically, like, governments, like, form a whole, like, coalition of agents for bioterrorism exclusively. And that's just a big thing. Like, because even though Umbrella goes away, the people behind Umbrella don't go away. They just change their name and keep doing what they're doing.
Ah.
So, like, Wesker is alive until the end of Resident Evil 5.
And that movie.
And that movie.
Which I did not see, except for that one time you and Adrian tricked me into watching that fucking terrible fucking glasses fling.
That was the best thing. That fight is scene for scene exactly like it is in the game, and it's the best thing I've ever seen. Fuck you, Snake. You're not even trying anymore, are you?
Me?
No, the fucking snake.
I'm shooting it in the face, dude. Like,
the fucking snake's just like, and then we just like, yep, nope.
And he shakes his head like,
you guys. You got
spin
me
around,
again.
We'll spin around this bookcase and try this one more time. Oh, he's confused now.
Yeah. Up here, dumbass.
I don't think he gets the concept here. What?
To shoot him in the mouth. Chandelier hit his head, he's all like, and then we shoot him in the mouth. Open your mouth, dude. There you go. Eat it. You saw. Oh! I was not prepared for that. It doesn't matter, this fucker's dead. Suck a dick.
Boom. Chakalaka.
Anyway, so by Resident Evil 5, you're playing Chris, which is the guy you are right now.
Okay.
And Sheva, who's a new character in Resident Evil 5, that they're part of the BSAA, I forget what it stands for, but it's like Bioterrorism Anti-Squad, and you end up in Africa because there's talk of more virus shit going around, and sure enough, zombies.
Virus shit.
And then you find out fucking Wesker's there. And then you kill him. Spoiler alert, I guess. It's an old game.
Yeah, if you haven't played it by now, you're not gonna fucking play it. Yeah,
And if you are, spoiler alert, don't listen to that last few couple of sentences. Mm.
Don't be an ass either. That was a short one.
Oh, did we get a new... I wonder... Oh, we did, right?
What?
We got... This is like a side quest or something.
Chapter?
Yeah. Oh. I wonder if it's because we were collecting those things.
Huh.
Hold on. I want to go check Resident Evil 0 real quick. See if we have any... Oh, we do. We'll go back to that later. Let's do a little side quest, yeah?
Yeah, that's good. Get her done.
Single player.
Boo.
Right. We'll stick with the multiplayer for now. It's on you, man.
Yeah. I just want to press A down here.
Yeah. Fucking game insists on making you point at the screen.
Yeah, shit. It's like, what was it? Mario Party? Like, fuck, oh, tap your amiibo any fucking chance you fucking get. Like, We're trying to make them important. Other than you just wanting them all.
Dude, seriously, E3 is just so inundated me with amiibo news. I think it's broken me out of, like, my
spell.
Yeah, yeah, like, I'm gonna finish getting all the Smash Brothers amiibo. But, like, other than that, I think I'm just gonna get ones I want. Like, I'll probably get Nook and Todekiki, but I'm not gonna get, like, all the other ones.
Just, like, ones you're interested in having yourself.
Yeah, and only if I can. Like, if I can't find them, then fuck it. If Nintendo's not gonna increase the supply, then, like, whatever. Fuck you, Nintendo. I'm still gonna buy all your shit, so...
Give me this one, fuck you. Got it. Oh, I had it. Stop moving me!
Man, we suck. Oh, we can shoot this fucker. Man, that... Blueface. Yeah, dude, he drowned, probably.
Fucking fishman shit.
I see you sitting there. You fool me for a second. Oh, I got it!
Turn, baby, turn.
Drown the pole, dude.
Yeah, look at me. My strong man arms. Yeah. Raising the damn dam.
Raising the damn dam. The dam and the dam. Oh, fuck. Where did you come from? You were the guy sitting down, weren't you?
I was totally the guy sitting down.
I told you, dude. I saw him there, man. Saw him sneaking around. I see you down there. Yeah.
Fucking...
Why are you turning around and jump down like you did from the second story of that fucking library?
You can't even, like, slide down the step ladder like a cool person.
Oh, snakes!
Oh, no!
At least they're not as big as that one we just fought. But they
swim. But they're not big either. Like, they're fucking little... What the... How did he cut me? Like, fucking...
Oh, they're a lot. They're a lot.
And now you decide to start once I'm done shooting you,
this
right?
This guy's coming! Ugh, he's dead!
You stop away on, like, your face, you fucking blue face.
Alright, we got the snakes, we got them. That's real nerve-wracking, because you know they're coming, like, they're just, like, inching towards you. Like, I dare you to fucking hit me. Gonna be a zombie right here, isn't there? Fucking snake or something. It's the worst. Zombie snakes, dude.
Zombie snakes.
Like, we had to deal with dogs and monkeys and now zombie snakes.
Seriously, puppy? Just stay down. Like, you got shot in the face. Stay down.
I'm usually really sad when dogs die, but I have no problem shooting these fuckers.
Hey, man, he wouldn't have stopped for you.
Oh, die, you fucker. Oh, you fucker.
Oh shit, I'm shooting you guys! Like, die!
Okay, I know I revealed something over there. Oh, it was a fucking... I don't know how to use this. I still don't know how to use it.
You just gotta click it? I don't want to click it and waste it, but I mean, like...
Nope. And, like, I swear that's, like, the one thing at the very beginning that I didn't read was the first aid spray. I read everything else.
Even the useless shit.
Especially the useless shit, because it was all useless shit. Then again, maybe I don't think it's useless because... we got it. Maybe I don't think it's useless because I did read it and understand it all.
There's, like, secret passage in there.
Yeah. I know you go in there in the game. I think it's where Lisa Trevor is... I think. Could be wrong about that. Oh! Where did you come from? See, like, these guys are looking only one direction. Let's go in there. These guys are only looking in one direction, and the guy just comes out in the peripheral.
Can't you move the thing, huh?
There's not a lot. That's it. Like, that's the...
There's a little head nod.
Yeah. These guys climb real slow.
I said they can't even, like, slide down like cool people.
I mean, that's like a rusted ladder though, so it probably wouldn't feel very good to slide.
Aren't they wearing gloves?
I don't know.
Oh! What the? fucking blizzard.
I forgot what they're called. They have a name. I wish I had a shotgun for them.
Gotcha.
Thank you, man. I love you. Oh, shit. Do you have any cover for that? We're quick time. They're just standing there, too. Like, we had to quick time for them to step to the side once. I guess we're fucking... I was going to say we're trapped, but no, there's plenty of room there.
I wonder if that's more nerve-wracking. Like, you think if it was, like, Wreck-It Ralph, though, like, they'd be there, like, hurry up. Do the quick time event. Shake your fucking control. Yeah. This boulder still hurts.
What would you do if you saw a spider like that, dude?
Dude, I'd cry. I'd run.
Like, zombie giant spiders.
Like, I'd question science because that's not supposed to work. The air is too thin.
Surely there is no God. I mean, look at them twitch, dude. They're dead. They're dead as dicks. They won't stop moving.
Look at the even in games, guy. It bothers me. Like, it's so bad. It's like, I was watching again those top 10 things that keep me entertained.
And then scare the shit out of you.
Yeah, this one like. Top 5 terrifying spider stories. It's like, oh Jesus, like one guy had like he went to sleep and he felt something felty on his pillow. And like just like the size of his fucking pillow, dude, like spider, like tarantula style, like
a single spider.
Yeah. And he was laying on it. Like, and there was another one where like one was like in a guy's bed, but he couldn't see it. And he would just feel moving around at night. So I guess it like lived around his bed area. And one day he like finally like felt it and like moved the blanket real quick, and it was like there, just chilling in between his legs. No, no.
That's funny.
Spiders, man. Like, I've been using my shotgun to spider talk. Fuck me.
I was sitting down with my dad earlier, and we were watching this, I don't know what it was, actually, he just had on, like, we weren't watching the TV, but he had it on, and, it was, like, some, like, shark dive thing, but not, like, in a cage, like, they were just in the water with the okay. sharks.
Did you get him?
And, my dad's like, yeah, I'd probably be freaking out if I were down there. I was like, I think I would too, but I'd be more freaking out about being underwater than I would about the sharks.
Yeah.
Not that I wouldn't be afraid of the sharks, but it's more like the...
I mean, like, I'm not the best swimmer, you know?
I'm fine at swimming, but, like, I don't want to drown. Like, that would freak me the fuck out. That'd be the biggest thing. I feel like the shark would, like, just pull a tube. They wouldn't even bite at me. They'd, like, kill me the fuck you way.
Oh, you want to take pictures? Yeah. Let's see how you can take pictures. No air!
Yeah.
Oh, man. It's...
And then I either drown or I go up and get the fucking bends. I was telling you how I was watching bad B-movies on Netflix. So there's this one on there that I actually really liked. It was called Would You Rather.
Oh, yeah. I've seen that.
Oh, okay. So you know what I'm talking about.
I haven't seen it, but I've seen
the... Oh, okay. Yeah. It's like... It's exactly what you think. It's basically some sadist, like...
Gets a group of people together.
And they're like, would you rather? But they actually have to do it, right? And, like, at one point, it was like he gave everybody that was left an envelope. And, they either had to do...
Was that a critical? Sorry.
I don't know, because the head blew up?
Yeah.
I don't know, I was shooting the dick.
It's fun, right?
It's kind of an accident. Oh, speaking of the water and sharks, because we're about to see that huge shark. Anyway, at one point, he gives everyone an envelope, and then he brings out a barrel, and the barrel's full of water, right? And he says, okay, would you rather... do what's in your envelope, but they don't know what it is until they open it, or have your head dunked in the water for 2 minutes. Right? So, ooh, I thought I was gonna miss that. So they basically had to, like, they were choosing the known or the unknown. That's the way the fucker put it, right? And, yeah, so the first two, well, I guess I don't want to spoil the movie, but basically, obviously, one of the characters ends up having to be in the water, and I just hold my breath the whole time, wondering if I would like last that long.
I think I was actually able to hold my breath for about 1:20, I think.
But yeah, I probably would have drowned. Although that character survived the 2 minutes. And if she had picked the envelope, she would have had all her teeth pulled out. So, lucked out, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, water over the... Actually, I had a dream last night about, like, my teeth falling out. And Vanessa said that I was grinding my teeth in my sleep.
Mm-hmm. Apparently, dreams where you lose your teeth are dreams about fear of mortality.
My birthday is Sunday. Saturday. Saturday.
Yeah, I've had a few teeth falling out before.
Yeah, also, well, I mean, I looked it up this morning. I've had it multiple times. And it's always the same way. Like, that, like, I feel, like, my teeth loose, and, like, the moment I stick my finger in my mouth to touch it or, like, check it, it just, like, beep, you know, like, comes out. And it's like, oh, that's terrifying.
Resist. Okay. No, mine are always I'm eating.
Okay.
Like every time I have it, I'm eating, and then I bite into something hard, and then what was that? And it was like a tooth that just came off.
You know, I've never been eating. It's always like I just happen to feel it, and I read it's like feeling of your appearance in front of others, and like I feel like. It could be something like that, too. You know, I don't know, like... Because it's always never on my teeth. It's just, like, a couple. And, I mean, like, I know me personally, like, if I was missing a couple, I'd be more self-conscious about that than, like, having all my teeth gone. Because, like, oh, like... I mean... I think I'd be more comfortable, like, with the fact that I was missing all my teeth than just a few. Because, it's like, you gotta explain, like, oh, this happened because it's stupid, you know, like... But it's like, why are you missing all your teeth? Because I'm an old bitch. Like,
and that man, that's hard.
And that can just be your excuse. We're aiming for that little...
I have no idea. I'm aiming for the little bulb at the bottom.
Yeah, and then when it opens its bulb lips, you see the clitter lips.
I'm sick of this shit because the fucking things keep going off camera and it's hard to shoot them off.
I don't think I have any other. Yeah, I don't have any weapons. Cool.
Oh,
that was a seed.
I wonder if we can shoot that arm before it gets to us so we don't end up getting stuck back down
here. Can you even shoot the arms? Is that a thing? Can you, like, blow up the arms? I'm really just aiming for this little sensitive area down here.
Ah, oh, come on! We're almost done. But as long as it keeps throwing us down here, probably taking a lot longer than we should be.
What's that? Why are you swinging your sex arm at me? For those who are following.
I don't think that's an octopus, man.
It's dead, though.
We don't know what it is, dude.
It's a plant. I know what it is.
Alright, a plant that moves.
Yeah, I played Resident Evil 1. It's a fucking plant.
Fucking.
See, it's wilting. There's little petals falling away.
Fucking Hellboy and this bitch.
I mean, it is a video game.
Remember when I was a video game?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Did we get an A rank on that files part?
Does that mean we got all the files?
I doubt it, because we probably need an S rank if we got all the files. Probably missed like one.
It's probably like the super secret one.
I mean, they're all pretty hidden. All right.
ER? Oh, it's Resident Evil? Not really. Right. Me. Let's do this. Oh, the fucking...
After fighting off an army of monsters, Chris and Jill stumbled upon a hidden underground research facility. There was no doubt that Wesker was here. The two carefully descended down into the darkness, not knowing what lurked below.
That really does end abruptly.
Yeah, it does.
Although, to be fair, it also scrolls real slowly, so you really have a lot of chance, a lot of opportunity to read it.
Eat a dick.
I wonder what makes them stumble. I mean, a person stumbles when they're like...
shot. Once?
Well, yeah, but that's usually because, not even pain. I mean, I'm sure it's pain. I don't know. I've never been shot.
I hope to never be shot. I hope you never get shot. That's scary, man. It's probably painful, too.
Probably. Yeah. Maybe it's like a movie where you can just get shot. Get shot multiple times and not even...
I blew that guy's head off.
Also, I don't really believe that. I'm not that stupid. But I feel like I have to say it. Fuck you!
I look like Wesker, dude.
That guy looked like he was, like, sewed up. The bloodiest cadaver. Oh, fuck you, zombie. See? I shot him. I knew it.
I can't tell if they're dead or not sometimes.
Yeah. Since they're, like, already dead. It's like, are they dead enough now? Do we need them more dead? Crimson heads. So in Resident Evil 1, if you would... Well, I don't know if this is true in the original. I know this was this was how the GameCube version worked. If you didn't burn a zombie corpse after you killed it, they might come back as Crimson Heads after a while.
Hmm.
And they were faster and harder to kill.
Yeah, we totally missed a secret. What? No. Kill it, dude. Like, double tap that bitch. Like,
I more than double tapped it, man.
Oh! No.
That's
okay.
A different one.
I was like, that's no! No! stop moving.
Yeah, they like...
Stop
like,
moving!
Like those fucking spiders, dude. They just, like, jiggle in place for a second. I'm gonna open the door, turn around, that fucker's gonna be coming at us. They're gonna destroy them. We suck. Power's out. There must be a switch. I think after we... Yeah, well, no mistaking, we find the power, we go up that elevator, and that's where we find Wesker.
And the tyrant.
Wesker. Why are we so bad at that?
Yeah, I don't know. Just shows how bad we'd be at firing real weapons. Cause that's like, cause when you pull the trigger, you move the remote a little bit.
Yeah.
So we're not hitting our targets. And you can tell too, like, how it moves to the left when I shoot. That's good to know, though, if I ever shoot a real gun. I shoot to the left. So I can aim to the right of whatever I want to hit.
Fuck.
Checkpoint. I keep thinking that's gonna be dialogue, but it's by just saying we're saving.
Yeah. Just gives them a chance to be sassy.
Sass stance. Sassafras. Oh. Thought it was red for a minute.
Not working. Is that what it said? I think that's what it said. Not working.
I think I broke it more by shooting it. Stupid machine. Thinking it's people. Damn right you're not working because no one's touching you.
Oh, snap. That thing's still alive. As is that. Abomination of life. Man, how did our health get so low? Did we get hit that much?
I don't remember. I think we haven't seen a potted plant in a while. Yo, fuck off.
They killed us!
No!
Wait! Oh, okay, so that's how they work. They just work when we're depleted.
Oh.
It's like a fairy.
Fucking champions.
Legend of Zelda. Alright. I'm glad I got that.
So, technically, still have not lost the game.
Yeah, technically.
Yeah, fuck everyone. We're champions.
Champion.
Don't believe it. I don't see a game over sign.
Did that spit on us?
I don't know.
We lost health. Legs are just waving in our face, dude. Get back to that elevator, dude. Motherfucking elevator.
Just let me shoot the light. I'm shooting the fucking light. No, dude, it bit me. Go on without me. I'll be back in game 5.
You probably will be.
No, I can't shoot the... Can't shoot the lights here. You ever been in one of those elevators with the... like... that kind of door?
No, I never have.
I've been. It even had like its own man inside of it.
Its own man?
Yeah, a man to open the thing for you. Mm. Yeah.
An elevator attendant?
Yes.
Where were you?
San Antonio.
Ah.
Yeah. She was like, my cousin was like, oh, yeah, there's a magic shop around here. And, like, you know, he took me and my family and shit. And it was a cool little place. They did that cool trick where there's a never ending water. Like, it's like a small container, but, like, just keeps pouring out. And, like, it pour out and it stops. And, like, huh, and then do it again. More comes out. It's like, oh, it's magic.
Fucking tyrant, dude.
Just
chilling there, dude. And this fucker.
Wesker? What the fuck, Wesker? You're inside, dude. You don't need those.
Seven minutes is all I can spare to play with you. He woke up tyrant.
Why you do this, Wesker?
I mean, is it really?
Yeah, like, have you seen how non-handsome he is? And his heart's outside.
Yeah.
He has no lips. I mean, it's sure.
Killed your ass.
Yeah.
Although not really. Because, yeah, plot reasons.
Reasons.
Yeah.
So, is it like a clone Wesker that comes later? Or?
No. So, I don't know. There's probably an actual explanation in some game somewhere that I don't remember. But Wesker is actually one of several Wesker children. And I think he's the only one that survived. I think him and the dude from Code Veronica were the only ones that survived. But I don't remember the whole story there.
See, because I've always been interested in the, like, Resident Evil storyline.
Oh, yeah, the storyline's real interesting. You're into it as a bit,
erratic.
I wasn't going to say that. I was going to say more like, it's not very believable. Okay. Like, completely out of left field, you know? It's, lots of plot holes, you know? But, it's interesting. You, like, it's just one of those things you have to suspend your disbelief far enough that, like, all this ridiculous shit happens somehow.
Science, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, science.
Science, bitch.
Did you call me?
That's a relevant meme right now. Or maybe it's not anymore. I don't know. I don't pay attention to that shit.
Meme. You just can't meme, but I don't pay attention to that shit meme.
Is it really a... It's not really a meme.
There's a meme for everything, dude.
Yeah, but, like, someone has to make it.
I'll make it.
And then people have to do it.
I'll make it and do it. Hard.
See, now Vanessa's gonna get after you. Because it doesn't matter what you meant.
Yeah. Make the meme hard, dude. Like, fucking and do that meme good and hard.
That guy looked like he was wearing a tie, but he's not wearing anything.
Where's your tie, guy? Ah,
I saved you. Yeah.
My reaction time was way slow.
Yeah. I like it. Like, I had already gotten him off of you by the time you started shaking. Oh, I hate these things. I forget what they're called. I wish I could remember what they're called. Hunters. They're hunters.
That was a whale.
What, when you call it a lizard person?
Yeah. Dude, the lizard person's coming. I wanna cut you!
Fucker spinning.
Oh, it does hit it! But they have to be, like, stupid close to you.
Yeah.
For the knife, and there's no point.
There is no point. Yeah. Because they hurt us. There's gotta be health somewhere. We need it.
Well, I was nowhere near shooting that, but it blew up. I wanted to, but when I fired, I know my cursor was not over it.
Are we at the roof already?
I just wish...
We are not at the roof yet. Alright.
Wish more lights acted like that one. Every other light, like, nope, you need to shoot me in this exact spot, or I will not blow up. Because I hate everyone.
We are dead.
Nah, man, we got this. We are fucking dead. This. No, I got cutscene, dude.
There's Rebecca.
Who's Rebecca?
Why
her? What is?
She's a member of our team.
We have to save that for later.
After Resident Evil Zero,
fire her. She let a criminal go.
Yeah, so she lets Billy go, and she ends up at this mansion, and then Chris ends up running into her. Although, obviously, in this particular game, you and I stay together the whole time. Jill and Chris actually separate in the game. And in Chris's story, you end up finding Rebecca, who ended up in the mansion after Resident Evil Zero. Now we're on the roof.
They couldn't just bring it. They had to make us sit in that elevator for no reason.
It was loading, probably.
Hey, like in Kingdom Hearts, like when it'll like cutscene, it's like walk down this hall, and then here's another 30-minute fucking cutscene. It's like why you do this? Like, you know, like.
Oh, we just got that in time. Spoke too soon.
That's it.
Ugh, you're pointing off screen.
I'm trying to get the herb.
Oh, I didn't get that.
I'm out of ammo.
Alright. Okay. I got him.
Bitch, face, motherfucker. Seriously?
We're okay for now. Oh, come on! Oh, come on!
Yo, are you on me?
Who else? Reloading. Oh, come on!
Joe and Hope, what was even that? Why we didn't get a chance in that one? Maybe we can knife him when he grabs us?
Not necessary, he's dead. Fuck you. The fucking Chicken Heart Vickers comes back to get us.
Chicken Heart Victor?
Vickers.
Oh.
So, Brad Vickers is the pilot. And the whole thing was, he drops us off in the forest. When the zombie dogs start coming at us, he takes off because he's a coward. And that's why the rest of the team ends up either dead or...
Why'd the mansion blow up?
Oh, that's just Resident Evil. We set off some self-destructive thing and that happens. That's why I said at the end of Resident Evil Zero that, like, oh, because it's a Resident Evil, the place is blowing up. That happens in every game. In the second one, you're in a facility under Raccoon City, that blows up. And in the third one, the whole city of Raccoon City blows up. That's terrible. But I had been reborn. I cast off my frail humanity and became something greater. So that fucker didn't die. Surprise, surprise.
Ah, could the virus. Damn!
We did better.
Dude, you like
I did better
retarded did the fucking objects.
Just because like, I blew shit up, yeah.
You went in there with like, you know, like bull in a glass shop style. Like, what's that term? Like a bull in a
China shop.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did like 5 times as many objects as you did.
I did beat you in the hits and the critical hits, though.
Yeah.
Which still got me a C.
Yeah. All right. And that's Resident Evil 1. Next time on Happy Hour, I think we'll go through Resident Evil 2.
Or some side
shit. Or 3 or something. Yeah, I think that's... I don't know.
Raccoon's just
one of those games.
Yeah. And yeah. Boo.
Yeah.